See, all the while we gave you the figure called CA in the DEXCOM. We always say CA is how much. Now, what we're going to do now is to learn how to compute the figure. You must determine the figure yourself, okay? Now, CA figure is actually a substitute for this thing called depreciation. That's why the formula to work out CA and the formula to work out depreciation is more or less the same, okay? Now, if you recall your depreciation, I don't know if you remember or not, in accounting, if you do depreciation, you take what? Cost, you times the percentage. Betul, that's how you calculate depreciation. So in tax, we also do the same thing. We also need to use a figure multiplied with a percentage. But we don't call it cost because we want to use our own formula. So what we call it, okay, if this is a CA, we call it qualifying plant expenditure. It's a qualifying expenditure. So it's expenditure that qualify, then only can come in, okay? Now then we also multiply with the rate. Now then we call that figure as CA, okay? Now, so the first thing we must understand is, what is a qualifying plant expenditure? Okay, now what is QPE? Okay, qualifying plant expenditure, if you see the definition here, right, it says is the capital expenditure. So it must be cost of the asset, capital expenditure, cost of the asset, okay? Now, for example, if you buy the aircon, how much you pay for the aircon? You say 10,000. That is the capital expenditure, which is 10,000, okay? Now, it's the capital expenditure incurred to provide machine or plant. Okay, machine or plant. So it must be a machine or it must be a plant. Now what is a machine? A machine normally must have those things that they have a movable or a non-movable part that they put together. Then because they start to operate, then the machine will start to work. That's called a machine, okay? So does that machine got movable, non-movable part put together? Then it start to work. Now then we understand what is called machine. But then what is called plant? Because if something is not a plant, then you cannot claim CA. Then we look at this room. Imagine this room. The table, do you call table machine? No, table cannot be machine. The chair you see got machine. Or not? There's no machine. So that does it mean, can I claim CA on the table or on the chair? Or not? So to decide whether or not you can claim CA, you ask yourself, is this table chair a plant? It's definitely not a machine, but is it a plant or not? If it's a plant, then you still can claim. That's why you must understand what is called plant, okay? Now, to look at what is called plant, now you see this page here, 183, okay? Now, this is the most famous case law that we use them to define what is called a plant, okay? Now, the case law says that a plant is whatever apparatus used by a businessman to carry on his business. Any apparatus that a businessman used to carry on his business, but it does not include stock in trade. That means stock cannot be plant. Because stock is what you sell, it's not what you use. Can you see? Stock cannot be plant. Okay? Now, then they say, is anything you use in the business, and nevertheless, it can be any goods or chattel, it can be fixed or movable, it can be live or dead. So a live one also can be plant. Now in this case, the plant is what? The plant are actually horses. The business involved in transport. Those days, where got lorry? When they got no lorry, then how they used to carry things? They buy donkeys, or they buy buffaloes, they buy horses. So the horses in those days will actually be car today, or lorry today. So then the question is, the money I pay to buy horses, can I claim CA or not? That's what we are saying, okay? Can we claim CA or can we depreciate or not, okay? That's what we are saying, okay? Now, so you imagine, there are a lot of businesses, they also have all these living things that they use in the business one. For example, you go to Zoo Negara, okay? In Zoo Negara, you see, they got a few elephants. Now, this elephant, they buy and they do what? Huh? They don't sell elephant, right? So elephant is not a sword and trade, ma. They don't barbecue elephant, right? So the elephant, they just put that to show only, correct? No? But this elephant, we buy back, we got to pay money, right? So can this elephant be a plant? Can or not? You go to school, the teacher give a slap, and you call elephant a plant. Elephant is animal, but text is so different, you see? The animal is also called a plant. Why? Because I need the elephant to use in my business to become a zoo, ma. See, I don't have elephant, no people visit my zoo. So that's why you see, in that case, the elephant is also a plant, okay? Now, so in that case, what's a plant? That means anything can be a plant. As long as it's something that you use it permanently for your business, it can be a plant. For example, maybe I am a barber. I cut hair, okay? So I spend 15,000 to buy the golden scissors. That scissors, the most important tool I need is a scissors, okay? Now the scissors is called plant, no? Yes. Because I need the scissors to run my business. No scissors, how to cut hair? So they said that scissors is a plant to me. So then you ask this person, can you claim CA on the scissors? Yes, why not? So you see, there are some businesses that plant can be very funny, very unique thing. For example, a lawyer. A lawyer, they need to buy a lot of books because they need to refer. So the books for a lawyer also called plant. That means the money they spend to buy books can claim CA, is it? Can. But the way they claim is a bit different. Follow, Now, so this is just a quick way to let you understand what is called plant. Okay, what's called plant. Okay, come back to this. So now the first thing I must know is I must calculate this figure. Because if I don't know what is QPE, I cannot get a CA. So I must calculate QPE first. So what make QPE? Okay, QPE is the cost, which is what they say here. The capital expenditure called the cost. Now, but we don't just have the cost. Now, you imagine, use common sense. If I buy the aircon, I go to the electric shop, I buy the aircon. The guy say, okay, this aircon one set, 2,000 ringgit. So I pay 2,000. I bring the one set back, the box back. Can I immediately use the aircon? Cannot, right? At least what must you do? Assemble, install. I must get people to come and fix it up, do the wiring, correct? No? You need to pay for all this, right? So all these expenses that you pay, they are incidental to the installation. They go together. So they are all taken as your qualifying expenditure. So it's not only the cost of the aircon. Now, so that's why in this case, we take the cost and we add what? We add all the expenses to do with altering your building. For example, if I want to fix one more aircon, I cut one more hole here. So the guy charged me 500 ringgit to cut a hole. 500, that's altering the building. Cost to install. The technician say, now install the aircon, we charge you 1,000 ringgit. Okay, the 1,000 is cost to install. Now this is the installation expenses. Now plus one more thing. Now this one special. That's one thing that sometimes students forget. Okay, that's why you must go back, you go through again, remember this. This is to do with prepare cut tunnel level land. Now I call this the cost to deal with the land. You see, sometimes there are those assets. Now maybe I buy an asset. Let's say I buy a power generator that I will fix outside my building. But my building outside, the land is not even. So I cannot fix it there. So I must get people to level the land first. Make it flat. So the contractor say, can I level for you? Leveling one time, 10,000 ringgit. Okay, I pay 10,000. But can I take the 10,000, put together and claim CA or not? It depends. So if you read up carefully, they say, if you spend money to prepare cut tunnel or level land, this cost can be qualifying, provided, now if you read, it say, if this expenditure exceeds 10% of the aggregate of itself and other expenditure being qualifying, then it will not apply. That means once you exceed the 10%, it won't apply. Okay? Now this is called land related cost. Okay? You must do a 10% test. Now I show you how to do. Okay? Now so now you listen to this example. Okay? Then you go back, you try one more time. If you can get it perfect, then very good. Then you are very well prepared for the exam. Now you see this example here. Okay, we have generator 1, generator 2, generator 3. These are the costs. These are the installation. These are tunneling land. These are training. training is revenue. You cannot claim CA one. You should know that training cost is revenue. You go and charge as an expense deduction. So I take this out. This one I don't want. Okay? Sure, the one. So now we only left with three figures. Now I need to know whether the figure is qualifying or not qualifying. Now by right there's no issue. The cost is definitely qualifying. This one definitely qualifying. This one also definitely qualifying. The only problem is I see this land tunneling. Then you must do what? You must do a 10% test. That's what you must do. Okay? A 10% test. Now how to do a 10% test? It says what? If you exceed 10% of the aggregate is by totaling. Aggregate of yourself and other expenditure. If you exceed, then it won't qualify. So what we do is like this. Now we take the cost, the installation, the land, you add everything together. Then only call aggregate. Now the cost is 65. The installation is 10. The land tunneling is 3. Now you add up all together, that is called the aggregate. So all add up is 78. Now we take 10% of it. How much is the 10%? 78. You answer me, okay? 78. So what do you do? You compare. You take this figure, because now I don't know whether the 3,000 qualify or not. So you take 3,000, you compare with the 78. Now you ask yourself, got exceed or not? No, right? Okay, then qualify or not? Qualify. So this is what we do, A and B. So we will normally do in exam this test, then we will write, since A does not exceed B, then A is qualifying. So how much is your QPE? 78,000. Follow or not? Okay, now we try one more. Okay. The second generator, the cost is how much? 65. Installation is 80. Installation is 12. Land tunneling is 18. So aggregate how much? 110. So you take 10%. So 11,000. So you tell me, qualify or don't qualify? No qualify. See, you understand the deal. Okay. Now, so now you need to remember the step. So this time, this one exceed. So if you put A exceeded B. Exceeded B. So A is not qualifying. So if A is not qualifying, then how much is the QP? Yes, 92. Okay. Then you ask, then what about the 18,000? Too bad. You lost it. You cannot get anything. Because the amount you spend is too high. Okay, see? So that was the purpose. They have a 10% bracket, a 10% ceiling. Break 10%, sorry. You can't do anything. You just waste the money. Now, but again, we're going to see one more. Now, you see example 3, you notice what's the difference in example 2. You agak-agak look at the figure, you see what's the difference. What is a bit unusual? I'm asking IQ question. 我问 IQ, 我不是问 text. What do you see? What's wrong with this figure in example 3? 有没有这么奇怪? What's so strange about the number you see there? You see the three number with generator 1, 2 and generator 3. What's so different in the number? Ayo, you don't see a difference. IQ question there. Hello. I'm not asking a text question. Now, you see example 3. The land tunneling is 400,000. But the cost of the generator is only 80. This is like what, you know? This is like you buy a car, 80,000. You spend 400,000 to do a car park. That sounds very funny, you know? The car only 80,000, the car park is 400,000. Now, the first example make more sense, man. The car is only 60,000. You pay 3,000 to make the car park. Okay, so that's why this is a very huge figure. Now, it's so huge that do you think you need a 10% test? I think you don't need to calculate, so you understand. Sure exceed the deed, correct not? Now, but because it's so big, there is actually one more rule. This is a special 75% rule. This is a rule that we'll see when we go to the next chapter, chapter 13, I think. All right. Chapter 11, sorry. Now, what rule is this? Okay. The same formula, the only difference is we change 10 to 75. Now, the amount is 80, 20, 400. So the aggregate is 500. Okay, the only difference is we change this to 75. So when you change this to 75, you realize that the 75 is 375,000. Now, then you compare. I don't want to call AB because this is two different figures. Okay, so I call XY. Now, if X more than Y, if X more than, must exceed. If exactly the same, not counted, must be more than. That means it must be more than 375,000. If exactly, no, it must be more than. So if X more than Y, then what will happen? We will take the aggregate and make it QBE. Q is qualifying. What is B? B is called building. Okay, qualifying building. Now we are talking about qualifying plan. Plan is for CA. So building is for what? IBA. It's a different allowance. Okay, so we will change the allowance into a different category. So in this case, you will say, sorry, you do not have QPE. But instead, we will give you QBE based on the 500,000. Now then you ask, what's the difference? The rate is different. Building, the rate is a bit slow, so you don't claim so fast. But plan, the rate is a bit high, you claim faster. Okay? Now that's the main difference between QBE, QPE. Follow up? Now, so I've explained this thing to you, the part to do with land related costs. Go back, do again. Okay? Make sure you remember. Now let me come to this part called Para 2E. Now this Para 2E is the GST effect. Alright, now what is this GST effect? Now this one also I think you should remember when we talk about income tax. Now let's say my business supposed to register GST. Suppose I must register GST. But I never register. I'm very bad. I purposely cheated the government. I don't want to register. I tempt. Suddenly, I go and buy a machine. Okay, this machine, the cost is 100,000. So when the seller sell me the machine, because the seller is GST registered, they will charge me 6,000 GST. So the amount I pay for this machine is 106, right? But I am not registered, I'm not registered. So I cannot claim input tax. So now the question is, when I want to claim CA, my cost of machine is 100 or 106? See, if I don't have GST registration, technically my cost is 106. And I should take 106 to calculate the CA, correct? But now the problem is your fault. You are supposed to register, but you never register. So the government blame you. If you don't need to register, then never mind. Let's say I'm a small business, my annual revenue is only 100,000. Then I don't need to register, then okay, then you can take 106. But if you're supposed to register, but you never register, you cheated the government, the government punish you and say, sorry, in that case, your cost is 100, not 106. The 6,000, you cannot claim CA. Now this is one, suppose, but never register. Or the other one is, if you are entitled to credit the amount. Whether you claim or you don't claim the credit, that's your problem. So if you're entitled to claim a credit, but you never claim back the input tax, then that's your problem. Okay? Now, you still cannot. So that's why those people who are under the GST cases, you have to beware. The amount you claim is based on the 100,000. Okay? Now, this is a GST issue. Okay? Come to this. These are all the examples. Now, look at page 184. Can you tell me again? CA is what times what? QPE times rate. Yes, very good. Okay, wow, see now you remember it. Okay, if you copy, you say 10 times or so, you don't know what you copy. Now the rates, percentage. Percentage got two. One is called IA, one is called AA. So what is IA and AA? A is allowance. Okay, what is I and what is A? Initial, annual. Now we guess and see the meaning. If you see the way it's called initial, you think how many times you can claim this? One, no? If not, why call initial? Correct, no? If I say something is double, if double can be three, must be two already. So that's why the word is called initial, means one time. Okay, one time. When that you claim that one time? You guess? Beginning, middle, or at the end? Why beginning? Initial, exactly. So you use, look at the word. It's called initial. One time, and it's at the beginning. So to us, what is called beginning? Beginning is the first year you buy the asset. The first year. Okay? Now to us, first year is what? First year is the asset available for you. That's called first year, not the year you pay the money. Now, for example, let's say my year end December. You listen, my year end December, okay? Now, so maybe on the 15th of December, I call a supplier, I say, hey, send me three aircon to my office. So the first send three aircon to my office. But then I say, I pay you next year, okay? I order the aircon come in December, you know? But I only settle the supply in January. So if like that, you tell me, this is considered you buy in December or buy in January? So we will still consider this is buy in December, because we take buy or we take incurred as available. When the asset is available, that is the date incurred. Now, initial is only given one time. And that one time is given when the amount is first incurred. Okay? Now, but you must fulfill the condition. We see the condition later. Alright? Number two. Annual allowance. Now, if you see annual allowance, how many times you gonna get this? Every year, right? Annual, every year. Okay. Now that's why it's given annually. Now I want to come back to account for a while. Okay. Depreciation is cost times rate, right? You tell me in account how long can you depreciate asset until fully depreciated? Okay. Number wise, when the number becomes zero, right? The number is what number? What is zero? Sorry? What? Sorry? Net book value. Very good. When the net book value becomes zero, you cannot depreciate. Can I know net book value? How do you get? How do you get net book value? Cost minus accumulated depreciation. Okay, now you tell me the tax concept. Depreciation you call what? CA. How do you get CA? QPE times the rate. Okay, rate got how many? Two. Got what? IA? AA, very good. Okay, so now how long can you claim? You claim until this figure becomes zero. It's the same with accounting. Okay, what is this figure? Now I'm telling you, the name of this term is called RE. Residual expenditure. Okay, now what is this figure? What is this? Cost, yeah, cost. But you don't call cost, you call what? QPE. And you minus, what is this? Yeah, accumulated depreciation. That means you minus the CA. So you minus until the balance becomes zero, then you cannot claim it. So it's the same with accounting, right? So if you look at it, it's so similar with accounting, it's not tough one, it's very simple. But I don't know why student exam I always make mistake. Okay, now, so now we understand this is called IA and AA. Okay, please come to page 184. This is important, the condition. Because if the conditions are not met, you cannot claim one. Okay? So if you say cannot claim, then how? Cannot claim means you missed it. You missed it. So you don't have, that's all. Okay? Now, so to claim initial allowance, these are the conditions. This must be first incurred. Now, I put inverted comma, first incurred. Actually, in the law, there's no such thing called first incurred. First is I use one to let us know that it's the first year. Now, how do they say this in the law? Now, they say this is incurred QPE during the basis period. Now, which word tell you is first year? This five word, the six word here, incurred QPE during the basis period, got six word. If you read this six word, which word tells you that that is called the first year? Incurred. No. I understand they are telling me it's the first year because they use the word during. During means during that year. 就在那一年, during, that means during that year. So the word during tell me that is the first year. Can you see not? So that's why in the exam they ask you, write me the condition to claim IA. You write that incurred qualifying plant expenditure, sure wrong one. Because no meaning. You must say incurred during the basis period. The word during is very important. Okay? Now, you must be second one, owner. You must own the asset. Okay? Number three, you must use the asset for your business. You must have a business. Now that's why you know by now, right? You should know already. CA is only for what? Business source, right? Got CA for employment or not? Don't have. Got CA for rental or not? Don't have. That's why you always understand CA is only meant for business. Because the law uses the condition business. Okay? Now this is called IA. Okay, turn to this page. What about AA? Okay. AA, if you see the condition, they say, one, you incurred QPE. Now you compare this condition and this condition. This is incurred QPE during the basis period. This one, they only say incurred the QPE. They never say during the basis period. So what does it mean? That means it's not the first year. You incurred. Incurred can be this year, incurred last year, incurred 5 years ago, incurred. It doesn't matter when you incurred. That means you don't have to be the first year. So long that you paid for it, Kennedy. That's called incurred. You are the owner of the asset. It's in use for business. Now, because they say you must be the owner of the asset until the end of the basis period, this will let us know that if you dispose an asset, that year when you sell asset, can you claim annual allowance? Cannot. Because when you sell the asset, you are not the owner already. Correct or not? Logic or not? You sell the asset, you are not the owner. So once you are not the owner, how to fulfill condition? Now that's why when you dispose asset, you have no AA in that year one. Understand? The year you sell, no allowance. That was the reason. Follow, okay? Now, so now you understand what is IA, what is AA, okay? Now, what are the rates you normally claim IA, AA? Okay, if you don't mind, can I show you the tax rate table that you have in the front page of your paper? Now, this is the rate that you'll be given in the exam. So I show you what you see in the exam. So at least you can know, you get familiarized with it. Now, in your exam paper, right, now you're going to see something like that. They gave you the initial and annual. Now, and they gave you this category, plant machinery, okay, motor vehicle, alright, heavy machine, office equipment, furniture fitting. Now, furniture fitting or others lah, line. Anything that they are not motor vehicle, heavy machine or not plant and machinery, then they call under line. Now, the initial rate you notice is always 20. Initial, the first year 20. Okay, then you see the annual rate can be 14, 20, 10. Okay, now that's why first year the CA very high one. Because first year got two rate, got IA rate, got AA rate. That's why first year very high, got IA, got AA. Okay, now so imagine if you buy a car, what is the rate for car? 20. Okay, so you look at the table, our table chair in this room. So what rate do you take? 20, 10. Because table, chair falls under furniture. Alright? So this fan, what do I take? 20, 10. Okay? My aircon? 20, 20, 10. No. Aircon falls into plant. Because it's not an office equipment, it's not a furniture, okay? So it falls into plant. Can say, no? So we take 20, 14, alright? So this is how we determine the rate. Now in the exam, you just have to be a bit more careful. Look at this and think carefully. You must use the right rate, you know. Because the rate wrong, your whole answer wrong one. For example, the furniture, examiner gave furniture in the question, you go and take 14%, then imagine all the figure got half mark, you lose all the mark, because your rate wrong, They don't have such thing called maka kesian or own figure rule. Why? Because the examiner said the rate given in the table. If the rate given in the table, you make mistake, it's your problem. Immediately we penalize you zero. That's why you must be very careful. Okay, now come back to this. Okay. Now, can we go back to this page 185? Now, this is something that student... they always miss out in the exam. So that's why you must listen and remember this. What is this? This is a rule that we say, if the asset not in use, okay, the asset not in use. Now, why would asset not in use? Okay, example, maybe that year I don't want to do business. I want a holiday 1 year, can or not? Why not? Okay, maybe I find that economy not good, alright, and then business was also weak. Okay, I close my shop 1 year. I go holiday. Then 1 year later, I come back. So the whole year, I didn't run business. So the asset all never used. Now, when asset all never used, can you claim allowance? Cannot. Because condition must be what? In use for the business. You never use, how to claim? So that's why you see, if you never use the asset, you cannot claim AA. There's no AA. But you don't have AA, never mind, no. There will be one punishment that the government will put on you. What's the punishment? Punishment is notional allowance will be computed to reduce your RE. This is a punishment. Again, remember, this is a punishment. Notional allowance is a punishment. What is the word notional? Notional is fake. Notional is fake. This is not a real thing. Okay? Now, so here example. Let's say you see I buy an asset is 100,000. The first year I claim IAAA. Now assuming it's 20K and 20K, okay? I claim IAAA 2020. So what will happen? In your tax, you will take your adjusted, then you minus CA how much? 40. Okay? Now, the RE from 100 dropped to 60. Second year. Now, second year, my asset I never use. I put one side. I didn't use the asset. So when I didn't use the asset, what will happen to my A? Kosong. You cannot claim AA. So when you cannot claim AA, the government say, we punish you. We will bring NA. So NA, it's a substitute of AA. Okay, NA is a substitute of AA. Tai San, Ti San. Okay, it's exactly the same as AA. So the NA is at what rate? The rate at AA. If your AA is 10%, NA also 10%. Now, so in this case, your AA 20, then 20. Now, so now you see, my RE dropped to 40 already. But in my tax, what will happen? My adjusted income, I want to minus CA. Don't have. This NA is not for you to minus the tax one. That's why it's a notional allowance. It's a fake thing. So you say, but what happened to me? What happened to you is your RE dropped to 40. So your allowance get lesser, do you? Now you imagine one more year you don't use. One more year you don't use, then NA one more time become 20. If one more year you don't use, NA one more time, zero. Then you start to use back, you say, I want to claim. Nothing left with you. This is the issue called NA. Follow, okay? That is how your AA and A comes in. Okay, come back to this. Look at page 186. Now class, we call this as ACA. Okay, we call this as ACA. Alright, now what is ACA? Okay, ACA is actually a privileged rate. The government give a higher rate than normal. Normally, like IA is 20, AA let's say is 10 or 14 or 20. Now I can increase the rate for you. Now, but these rates all quite old, yeah. So I'm not so keen about going through all the rate. But you ask me, do I have to memorize this in the exam? Of course, because they won't give the rate to you. You must remember yourself, okay? But you ask me, then how often the examiner will ask this sort of thing? Right? Now, the very old one, I don't see they ask. Because the examiner also felt, don't want to be so unfair. I mean, the rule is 2001. Okay, so old already, 2001, probably some of you only 10 years old. Can see, you know? They want to test the rule. That's why sometimes examiner is a bit considerate. They don't ask a very old thing. Now, they normally ask the new one. Okay, the new one. So the new one, the more recent one, is only left with computer. But the rest all also expired. Okay, only left with computer. Now, what's wrong with computer? Now, to encourage people to spend money on the IT system, we allow them to claim a rate faster than usual. How fast? 2080. That means 1 year you claim fully. Understand? No? 1 year you claim fully. So when you claim full, what is the advantage you're going to have? You pay less tax. Okay, you pay less tax. Imagine I'm an IT company. So when I start, I go and buy all the software, buy all the computer system, I spend $500,000. So 1 year I claim all the $500,000, but I don't even have income. My income very little, only 60,000. Then good for you. Your income 60, your CA 500, you got no SI. Then you carry forward next year. Next year also no income, then again no SI. Then you carry forward, then a few years you don't need to pay tax. So that was the advantage. The government let you claim first, because you know, to encourage you to spend the money. Now this is called ACA. Now then my notes here in page 187. Now this rule on security control, that one you cut it off. This one no more, yeah, expired. Your question will not come to 2015. This is until 2015, so we don't care. Okay. Now but in page 188, that one, yes, that one still apply. That one extended. This is for what? IT equipment. IT hardware, software, all included. Hardware, software, all included. Okay? Now, that's to do with IT. Okay? So, this is what we mean by the basic way of claiming capital allowance. Alright? Now, can we come to this page? 190. Okay. Part A. Now they would like us to compute the CA, the balancing charge, balancing allowance. Now what is balancing charge and balancing allowance? In accounting, balancing charge is you make what? Gain on disposal. Allowance is a loss on disposal. Okay, how do you calculate gain loss on disposal? What's the formula? In accounting, when you sell asset, you take what minus what? Sales proceed minus net book value. Now, you're telling me it's the sales proceed minus net book value. Okay, you tell me in tax, net book value call what? Residual expenditure. See, the figure all same one. Okay, just a different term only. Now, then we don't call sales proceed, we call disposal value. So if your disposal value more than RE, you make a profit. Then you call that profit as what? Balancing charge. If your disposal more than the less than the RE, you make a loss. Then you call that balancing allowance. Simple, no? Very simple, right? Okay. Now, so we read these. Okay, I'll let you try it. Now, Maury closes their account 31st December. Okay, in 2014, they incurred all this. The cost of the aircon is 35,000. They buy computer 180, they buy power plant 60. Now you see the date of acquisition all given. Now the year end is December, right? But you see the date they buy the asset, December also they buy, July also they buy, March also they buy. Now then you ask, does this affect my CA or not? Because in depreciation, some company policy is if you don't buy asset for full year, right, you must time a portion. What about CA? CA don't have one. Our rule is very straightforward. You claim full amount. CA, we will not time a portion. That's why for CA purpose, is it good to buy asset beginning of the year or end of the year? Which one is better? Beginning better or end better? End. Because end you buy, you claim first, ma. Now let's say example. Now my year end is December. Okay? Now I plan to buy a machine 1 million ringgit. Now I only plan to buy the machine, for example, I plan to buy the machine next year January. If I buy next year January, then the 1 million incur in 2017. But if I bring forward, I buy in December, 1 month earlier only, you know, then I can claim the CA for that 1 million only. So to me, I can increase the speed of using the CA. So it reduces my income. So that's why CA wise, it's always good to spend the money earlier. Because there's no difference. You buy December, also you claim. You buy January, also you claim. Follow now? You don't time a portion. Okay, these are the costs. Now, then they say, Mori pay installation 20,000 for the computer. Now the building renovation cost, renovate the building. Why? Because they want to install the aircon. Is 5,000. Okay, the power plant, they need to install it beside the factory. To install the power plant is 20,000, but they say include the 20, include 10,000 to what? Clear the land. Like you tell me, you see the clear the land, what crossed your mind? 10%, okay? 10% test. Wow, very effective. Now you all know, okay? 10% test. Okay, so up to this stage, you tell me how many assets you have? How many assets you see here? 3. Aircon, computer, power plant. Correct or not? Okay, so you got 3 assets, right? You do this for me. So now I let you do the work. If not, later you fall asleep. Calculate for me, for this aircon, computer, and the power plant, how much is the QPE? You just add the figure up. Those who need to test or don't need to test, whatever you must do, you go and do yourself. Okay? Just show me how much is this 3 figure. You quickly go and calculate. I do here. So as I say, you go back, you do one more time. Okay? Just do one more time. Doesn't matter. Because you do one more time just to make sure you really remember. Now you see how many asset you have. Then how many CA you must calculate. That is how you start. Because you look at the question so long, you say, I don't know how to start. Okay, how many assets you have is how many CA you need to calculate. So I got 3 assets. So when I got 3 assets, I will first calculate the qualifying plant expenditure. Now first, my cost, 35, 180, and then 60. Now installation, computer is 20. Aircon is 5. Because you need to renovate to install. That's why it qualifies. Alteration. Renovate to install. Then for the power plant is 10. Because the 20,000 included 10. That means the 10,000 installation. So now the only thing is left with what? Clear land. That one I don't know this qualify or not. This one. How do you know it qualify or not? We do a test. So I do a test here. Okay, I do a test here. So what I'll do is I will take the 60, the 10, and to clear land another 10, add them up, and you call that aggregate 80. Then you take 10%. So you get 8,000. A, B. So what happened? A exceeded B, so A is not QPE. Correct not? So you put a nil in the answer. $40,270. You get perfect or not? If you get perfect lah, you get perfect like that, at least got 5 marks already. Huh? See, so easy. You just need to know the rule. You can do already. Alright? And you see these 5 marks, you don't look down on the 5 mark, you know. Huh? 不可以看小这5分, why? Because if you make a mistake here with the number, right, everything go down all wrong. Now, example, just now, like our friend say, the aircon, I take 35. He didn't take 40. Then he go and calculate the IAAA. The IAAA take 20, 14. The rate correct. But the figure wrong. The figure wrong. It's 35 times 20%. Examiner only allocate half mark. You think examiner give him the mark or not? Examiner say, cannot give. I tell you why cannot give. Examiner say, nah, you see, the rate is given in the question. Rate give you a D, ma, the table give you a D, correct? Not? That means when the rate given, I'm not testing you anything already, you know. If I'm not testing you anything, somehow you made a mistake in the figure, so I give marks to you, then I'm giving you 3 marks. That's why from this angle, that is why I'm telling you why students go exam, either they score very well or they score very bad. Because they made a mistake on top, everything down all wrong already. So please be very careful. Understand? Okay? Okay, so can we now go back to the question? I haven't finished reading. Go on. Okay. All assets put to use immediately after installation, except the aircon. Okay? Except the aircon. That is not used until 5th January 2016. Okay, you tell me which year they buy. 1A, YA, 1-4. 1-4 is the first year, right? Now, YA, 1-4 is your first year. But what's wrong with the aircon? They say they didn't start using the aircon until 5th January 1-5. So, 1-5 is which year? 1-5, second year. So what's wrong with the aircon then? You never use them. And when you never use, what's wrong with the CA? Cannot claim. And when you cannot claim AA, what must come in? Notional. Very good. Okay. See, now you master the rule. Okay. So in the exam, please don't forget all these rules. Now, carry on. Then they say, the power plant was not used at all for 2015. So now aircon is first year never used. Power plant is second year never used. Okay? Now then the last part, they say in 2017, they sell off all their assets. Now when they sell their asset, these are the value they are selling. 12,000, 10,000, 45,000, they dispose all the assets. Now then they are telling you the rate. They say 80% is the AA rate for computer. 14% will be for the aircon and the power plant. Now you see, Okay. What is my first year? YA? 14. Okay, IA, AA, NA. Now, in the exam, must write the percentage at the side. Okay? Not just the figure, the percentage also. Alright, write the percentage. Now, so IA is 20%. Okay, 20%. So, aircon, can claim or not? Aircon, cannot. Why cannot? Not in use, so nil. Now AA 14%, can claim or not? Cannot, not in use. So if cannot claim, what happened? NA come in. So you have 5,006. See, so simple. Now, what about computer? 20, 80. So 40,000 and 160. Now what about the power plant? 20, 14. So 14,000, and then the other figure is 9,008. Now I put at the side is to show you how much will be the CA that you claim. Claim is what? Claim is reduce your income. That is called claim. Now which one can claim? IA, AA can claim. NA cannot claim. That means in that year you only can claim 2238. That one you can claim. Okay. After QPE, you minus all these, what do you get? You get what? RE. Okay, you get RE. Now, do I need to show every year RE or not? I don't know. You see the question. Because sometimes examiner requirement will say you must show the CA, the RE. If the examiner says must show RE, you better show. Because every RE might give you half mark one, you know. If the examiner say. So imagine you don't want to show. You just leave out this figure, then you lost the half mark. Okay? Now, so this is my figure. 30,404. New. And then 70,462. Okay, now you see, coming to 2015. Do you still have IA? No more. Okay, no more. Now AA and A. So you will not get IA anymore. Now I just put a dash instead of deal, nil, okay? Now you get IA for your aircon. Now, will you still have any allowance for computer? Because understood kosong already, right? You see, in the exam, this is something I also don't agree with the examiner. Okay, but he is like that one. So I better tell you, so you must remember, okay? Now, I look at it, already kosong, what is there to calculate? Agree or not? I mean, calculate is so stupid, it's kosong, calculate is all kosong. But the kosong got mark one, you know. You put a new there, got half mark. So if imagine you say, hey, kosong, understood, don't need to calculate. He still want to give mark. Chinese say mangsa. Okay? Now, you must put a new also. Put a new, okay? Then power plant, sorry, because not in use. So you only can claim 5,006. So understand, So now you go on. Claim for one last year, AA, 5,006, new, 9,008, okay? So once you come to 2016, okay? Once you come to 2016, now I take that as the last year, why? Because 2017, you're doing what? Disposal. So this is your RE already. Okay, now I just show the last RE that I need, 34,400. 23,200 new and 26,600. This is your RE. Okay. So in 2017, you dispose. Plus, when you dispose asset, what do? You take disposal value, you minus the RE. Okay, the disposal value you can see from the question there. Aircon you sell for 12, 10, 45. Okay, RE is the figure on top, 23,200, new, 26,600. So you will have a balancing charge if it's a profit, balancing allowance if it's a loss. So you see 12,000 minus 23,200, what do you get? 11,200. That is called BA. 10,000 is BC. 45,000 minus 26,600 is 18,400 BC. Now, so I ask you, for fun only, disposal value is 5K. This one is not the answer. RE is 5K. Okay? What do you write? You write new. Okay? What do you write here? Don't write anything. Write what? Now you see here, right? If you write BA, BC, new, you get marked. If you just write BA, no mark. Or if you just write BC, also no mark. You don't write, also no mark. Wow, like that one, yeah. Because examiner say, you got to understand, When you say kneel, you say BA kneel, then got BC, is it? If you say BA is kneel, then is it got BC? Don't have, huh? Now you say BC kneel, is it got BA? Don't have also, That's why you must say BA, BC kneel. Then you say, I don't write. You don't write, examiner say what? You don't know. That's why you don't write. You see, this is how they do the marking. That's why these are questions. You make mistake easily and lose mark. So not worthy. That's why I say you must understand what you must do. Go exam and do properly. Okay? Now class, I finish all the calculation part with you. Okay? Okay. So now we look at this part. Okay. This is to show you how the whole thing fit in. The TaxCom fit in to complete the big picture. Now we're telling you that calculate for me the tax liability for 2014 with this additional information. The business adjusted income, the dividend, zakat, interest from bank that matured on 16 November, unabsorbed loss brought forward, donation to charity is 20, to government is 50, plus the donation to project of national interest. Now, I just give you extra 7 figure on it. So now you show me for the company in 2014, how much is the CI and how much tax the company must pay. Okay? So what you're going to do now? Arrange. This is nothing new. This is doing arrangement. Just arrange back nicely on it. Okay? Arrange back the figure. Now you try this. If you don't want to do it in the paper so that you want to do it again, then you do it separately. Okay, give it a few minutes. You give it. Okay. Now, I make use of the space in page 191. If you go back, you can try again. Okay. Don't quit. Better not. Don't squeeze. Okay. I use here. Now, we are doing Y14. You start off with business and adjusted income said to be 840. Now you must know what come after adjusted, right? Capital allowance. Okay, the mistake that some student might do is the student go and take the BC and charge inside the BA minus. Now you do like that, then it's very wrong because this one is 2017 punya problem. Now it's 2014. Please don't go all the way to the future. Okay? Now you still don't have BA, BC. Okay? Now the CA for 2014 how much? 2,23,800. That's why notional don't have one. Okay? 2,23,800. So the SI for business. Now there's only one business here. So if there's only one business, then you minus your unabsorbed business loss brought forward, 30,000. So the net business SI will be 5,862. Now once you finish your business, then you bring in the investment income. Now we notice there's 4C dividend nil, 4C interest. You tax the interest, right? Because interest matured during that year. So 6,000. Now dividend taken, interest taken. So 5,922, what do you call this? Aggregate, okay? You call this as aggregate. Now, at aggregate, what do you minus? Normally, the first thing is current year business loss. But you don't have, right? Okay, you don't have, then you minus donation. Now, how many donation you're seeing now? You don't need to follow sequence. Zakat is the first one. How many percent? 2.5 of
5922.
Let's see whether it exceeds 2.5 or not. 14,000. Yeah, so you restrict to 14,000. Now then you have the donation to charity. Now the one maximum is 10% of 5922. So 20,000, okay, are within limit. Now then donating to the state government got no limit, 50,000. Now finally, project of national interest. Now this one, the maximum is 10% of 5922 minus of the 20. You must take out the section 446 to charity. So you're left with 59,220 minus 20 is 39,220. But your project is only 16,000. Okay, ma? Huh? So you minus all the 16. So 5922 minus 14805 minus 70 minus 16. You have 491395. Am I right? Correct, huh? Now, so what you do is you just have to work out the tax. Okay, now the question never say this company is big or small, so normally if they never say, then we assume. Okay, if you want, you can just assume that this is not a small company, and then you multiply with 24, and then that's your tax payable. Okay, pretty straightforward, lah, huh? Hopefully you can handle. Then you'll be very safe in examining. Okay, can you go to page 193? So we continue our discussion. Okay. I go on, go back and watch the video purposely, if not you don't watch. Now okay, the issue about ownership. Okay, why do I want to discuss this? See, in real life you have a lot of situation like that. You want to buy a car, then you realize that maybe you don't want to put your name for whatever reason. You say, mother, I buy the car, I put your name, but I'll pay the installment, but I put your name, I borrow your name. Okay, so that car I buy, I put your name, I pay installment, then I use the car for my business, then can I claim CA or not? Because the condition to claim CA is what? Incurred, correct? Not incurred, owner in use. Now incurred, owner in use, so this gives us an issue of ownership issue, So owner doesn't need to be legal owner, it can also be a beneficial owner. What is a beneficial owner? Beneficial owner means the substance. I'm paying for it, but I didn't have my name there. Never mind, I'm still a owner. Because this car I pay one, but I did never register my name. I put my mother's name. I am called a beneficial owner. What is my mother? Legal owner. Okay? A legal owner. So now the question is, if you want to buy a car like that, for example, my case, I buy my car, I put my mother's name, I use for my business, can I claim? Now, because I pay for the car, I'm a beneficial owner, I use in my business, okay, I still can claim. Now we make it a more different situation. You want to start a business. Now you want to start a business. Your father say, okay, I buy you a car. I buy you. I pay. You know money, man. I pay. Your father buy. Okay. Your father say, put your name. I buy. I pay. Put your name. You use. Can you claim? Now, so in this case, you say that my father paid, so you never incur law. Are you owner? Yes, you are legal owner. Okay? You use in the business? Yes, but you never incur, so you cannot claim. Then what about your father? Your father incurred. Is your father owner? Yes, your father pay ma, so he's a beneficial owner. But did your father use? No. So your father also cannot claim. So in that case, what happened to the car? Ah, wasted lor. No one can claim. You also cannot. Your father also cannot. Okay? Ah, so this is a situation that we talk about ownership. Understand? Now sometimes this kind of ownership issue might apply to cases where you have a joint ownership. Now what is a joint ownership? Now house, you want to buy two names, you were here before, right? Car buy two names, you were here before. Huh? You walk into Toyota tomorrow, you get a try. You go in, they say, okay, I like this car, I'm going to buy the Camry. They say, buy under whose name? They say, we want to put our two names together. If cannot put two names, we won't buy. You say like that, the next thing, they'll take the mop and kick you out. Can you know? Because car, how to register two names? You only put one name there. Can you know? So now, this situation come in like this. We have a case where Abraham and Madeline, they jointly buy a second-hand van for $120,000 on 16th of April 2015. Now, for this van, Abraham will pay 60%. Madeline will pay 40%. So who pay more? Abraham pay more. Because Abraham is the big one. So he said, then fair lah, I should put my name lor. I pay more ma. So that's why Abraham go and register as the owner lah. Is the major player, major payer, so he become the owner of the van. But this van will be used by both Abraham and Madeline in their own business. Maybe they share, just a taxi driver. We buy the taxi together, morning I drive, night you drive, so we share the taxi. So that's why now you see, but the name, only one name. So I pay more, I put my name, you don't put your name. So this is a situation like that. So can they claim the CA or not? Now, Abraham and Madeline, did they pay? Yes. Are they owner? Abraham, yes. Both legal and beneficial. Madeline also, yes, beneficial. Not legal, but beneficial, because she pay ma. Got used in their business? Yes. So can they claim CA? Can. So you say if they can claim, then how do they claim? They claim the respective amount that they pay. That means for Abraham, he will take how much? Which is 72K. No? And then you go and multiply the rate. Vehicle, tell me what's the rate? 20-20, yes. So Abraham will take 20%, 20% on the 72. Madeline will take 40, 8,000. And claim 2020. Okay, now this is how it affects a person on terms in terms of the ownership issue. Follow on. Okay, now we go on to this. Okay, in the tax law, right, there is one part of the law that they deal specifically with this thing called hire purchase. What is hire purchase? What's hire purchase? Hire purchase is when you want to buy something, you have no money, then you take loan. But this is not take loan, you know. This is a hire purchase agreement. Because it's controlled under the law. Different part of law that deals with hire purchase. Can you see that? Okay? Now, so hire purchase is given very specifically in the tax law. How to deal with hire purchase. Now, what's wrong when you deal with hire purchase? You pay by installment. Fair enough? You pay by installment. So when you pay installment, the timing you incur the money become spread out. So if the timing you incur spread out, then how will you claim the CA? You must also spread out. Now you must see different between take loan and take hire purchase. Now let's say for example, you're gonna start a business. You wanna buy a machine. This machine costs about 20,000 ringgit. You got no money. You want to take half purchase, but there's no half purchase for this machine. So you think, you don't know how to take. You say, I remember my credit card credit limit got 30,000. So you call the bank. Hello, bank. I want to take a credit card loan. You give me 20,000 loan. Then credit card asks you, how many month installment? You say, I want to pay 36 months. Then the bank calculator and say, okay, every month you pay this amount. But then poke 30,000 go into your bank account. So you take 20,000 go into your bank account. You take the money out. You go to the shop, you say, nah, I want to buy the machine, you pay 20K. So now you're taking a loan, right? But the machine you buy cash, what? Because you take 20,000 out and buy the machine, ma. So it's why in that case, this machine, how much is the QP? 20? Because you buy cash. You're taking loan is a different issue. But the machine you buy cash. But hard purchase is different. Higher purchase is you agreed with the hirer that you will pay by installment, okay? That's called half purchase. Now, half purchase interest, how they charge? You want to buy a car, how do you calculate the interest? Now, I show you, if you don't know, this is how you learn. Let's say you want to buy a car, 100,000. Normally, you must have down payment, right? If you don't have down payment, what you do? You trade in your old car. Lo. So when you trade in, means you sell the car to them, but you don't take the money. Now let's say you put a 10,000 down payment. You pay cash, pay cash down payment, or you call deposit. So balance 90, what you do? You borrow. Okay? Half purchase interest, very low one. How many percent if it's a new car? 3%. Wow, you all know very well. You all keep buying car one. Okay, I also don't know, you know. Okay? Alright, okay, 3%. Actually, if you buy more expensive car, the interest is even lower. Seriously, you go and buy Mercedes Benz and see, they can get 2 point something one. Can you see, because high value ma, the bank earn more. You buy Proton or MyV, that one very high interest rate, because the bank also no meat to eat. Your loan so cheap, can you see, okay, never mind. So 3%. How long you want to borrow? You tell the bank, I want to borrow 6 months. The bank will take penyapu and whack you, ask you to get lost. Can you know? You tell the bank, I borrow 1 year, also don't have one. 1, 2 year, they never lend you one. Because 1 year lend you 3%, they lose money already. Now, they say minimum 5 years. Or better still, 9 years. Go for 9 years. They ask you go for 9 years. Can you know? They like you to go long one. Okay? So let's say you take 9 years, 3%. That means 27. So 27, your interest become 24,300. 90,000 divide by 9 years, divide by 12 months, that is your installment per month. So car loan is what? Straight line. That's why the interest very cheap, but actually it's very expensive. Why? Because over the year, you paying the installment, the amount drop already, you know. But we still take 3%. That's why if this 3% per year, you convert back to effective interest rate, is anytime higher than your house loan. That's why you don't know. Okay? So don't say it's cheap. It's not cheap. So don't say, wow, 3.8, very cheap, ma. My housing loan is 7%. It's more expensive than your housing loan because it's straight line. It's not reducing balance. Okay? You must understand the difference. All right? Now, so this is how we work out HP. So now we want to see how HP affects my CH. So I take one simple example to start with. Look at this illustration one. Now this one, very straightforward, no deposit issue. Okay. Now they say, Wu Liao Berhad acquire a machine on half purchase from Ji Liao Berhad on 1st April 2013. The year end is December, they buy in April. Now the cost of the machine is 72. I take full loan. I got no money. Full loan. That means I borrow all the 72. Then the company say, okay, you are borrow 72, we charge you interest 18,000. So in total, you must pay 90,000. You want to borrow 24 months. So every month, you must pay 3750. Now this 3750 got two figures. Got capital repayment and got interest. So how much is the capital, how much is the interest? Now actually it's very simple, because it's straight line. Capital divide 24 is the capital. interest divide 24 is the interest. Now you see capital is 72. If I divide by 24, it's 3,000. So if monthly is 750, that means interest is 750. You take 18 divide 24, also 750. Now this one you claim CA. This one what do you do? Interest, expense, deduction. Okay. Now you know already, every month you pay 3,000. Okay? If you start paying in April, you start paying in April. Your year end is December. I want to know, in 2013, how much have you paid? How many months? 9 months. 9 times 3 is 27. Can you take 72K and claim CA? Cannot, lo. Because you didn't pay, ma. Incurred is the keyword. Incurred. You never pay. How to claim? That is the catch of half purchase. So the catch of half purchase is, we say, the amount you incurred is based on the repayment. So what's your repayment? In YA, that year is which year? Y13. You pay 9 months. Y14? 12. Y15? 3. Correct. Right? But I don't take 375 because that one include interest. Now, so that means in YA 13, 14, 15. Now, in fact, I do like that. I don't want the 14, 15 first because we imagine year by year. Now I'm in YA 13. I still don't know what happened in 14 and 15. Now, YA 13, according to the term, I must pay installment. So I pay. I pay 9 months already. So I'm going to calculate my CA. How much is my CA? Now, we say you incurred 27K. Okay, 27K, what you do? You claim IA and AA. Okay, this is 2013. So IA, AA. What's the rate? 20 and 14. Machine, 20 and 14. Now you see, 27,000 will be 5,004. And then it become 378. Now I leave the RE with you. Now, can we ignore 2014 and so on? Let us just ask ourselves, what will happen for the following year in 2014 for this figure? Do you still have IA? No more D. You know no more D, right? Now, will you claim A? Yes, you claim 3, 7, 8. And it just goes on like that, right? Until you finish. Am I right? Okay, but do you notice, when you come to 2014, you pay the next installment. So when you pay the next installment, you're paying another 36,000. Now this 36 must claim, right? So that's why now you must understand, in Y14 you pay another 36. So is this first year? Yes, it's first year for 14, no? It's the first year for 14. So if first year for 14, what can you do? You can claim IA, exactly. So you claim IA 7,200. Then you claim AA 5,040. Now class, if you go on to the next year again, now you know these two figures got no more IA, right? And what you do with AA? You just continue claiming. And now you know what happened today, right? What happened in 2015? You pay one last installment, another 9,000. And that one is the first time in that year. So you're going to say, oh, I will claim IA 1008. And then the 9,000 will claim 1260. So you notice this is like a staircase. It becomes more and more. Because first time you pay lesser. Then the second year, you will take whatever you pay first year plus the second year. Then the third year is first year, second year, third year. And then you keep on accumulate the allowance. So the allowance grow bigger and bigger. But whatever in the first year you claim first, you finish first. So towards the end, the allowance become lesser and lesser, lesser and lesser. So it become like that one, the pattern. You start little bit, you get more and more, then slowly become lesser and lesser. Because, you know, so it's like that. starting is little bit, then get more and more, more and more, then get lesser again. You can say, now, so you're going to imagine that figure become in this way. Now, so now we go on with the following few years. Okay, Y16, I only have A8. 3, 7, 8, 5, 0, 4, 1, 2, 6, 0. Now, YA17, we claim AA. 3, 7, 8, 5, 0, 4, 0, 1, 2, 6, 0. Okay. If your rate is 14%, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is 70% already. Plus the 20 is already 90. How much left? 10%. So if amount is 27, left with 27. See, you don't need to calculate one. You just need to get used to it. 习惯你就知道了. You get used to it. You just say, 14%, 5 times, then left with 10%. Slowly you get used to it. That's why I say you must do until you get familiarized, then become very fast with it. Okay? Now, so when you come to 2018, obviously you cannot take 378 because you got not enough RE. You only have 27. Then 5, 0, 4, 0, 1, 2, 6, 0. Then this figure will be the second figure that will be finishing. Left with? Yes, 3006. Then for Y19, your AA, this one no more already. This one you still have 3006. This one is 1260. So this one finish. This one left with? 900. So YA 2020, your AA, last one, 900, the rest all finish. Now you see, this is how the claim pattern will be. Follow? Now that is how higher purchase will affect us. Now in the exam, if they ask you to show RE, then you must show RE. If they ask you how much they can claim, then you must add the total. Okay? So this is what you must do. So I already show you the initial stage. This is how half purchase will affect us. But there's one more example here in illustration 2. Page 194 again. There's example 2. Okay. Now we're going to take a break. Alright. So after you come back from the break, why not you try this example 2. Take a piece of paper and do. Okay. Then we come back, we do. You compare and see your answer same or not same. Test your knowledge. Okay. Okay, right, I will go through this illustration 2 with you. Now, RZ purchased office equipment on the 19th June 2011. Cost is 20, deposit 2. That means you borrow 18,000. Now, the monthly installment 900, the one tipu one. Because you must break down the capital and the interest. Now they start paying in July, then they say in September they dispose this for 9,006. Okay, the first thing I need to know is my HP loan is 20 minus 2, so I borrow 18,000. If I borrow 18,000, then 1 month how much is my capital? Now I take 18,000, I divide by 20. 24 month installment. So 18 divided by 24, the main installment is 750. So how much I incurred for the respective year? Now YA 2011, that's the year you start. So 2011, now you pay deposit first, then you pay 750. And you start paying in July, your year end is December, so you pay 6 months. Then 2012, you pay another 12 months. Then 2013, you pay 6 months. That means the qualifying expenditure will be 4,005, 9,000, 6,005. Now you first must get all the figure, okay? Now once you've got all the figure, now you can start claiming it. So 2011, my QPE is 6,005. So I start off with 2011 IAAA. Now office equipment, the AA rate is 10%. So 1,003,650. Now coming to 2012, I pay another 9,000. So why 2012 IAAA? Now this one only have AA only, IA no more. But this one I can claim IA as well as AA. Then coming to 2013, I pay another 4,005. Now you put a total to claim yourself. That one you add yourself. Okay. So coming to 2013, we have IA and AA. So I only left with AA for the first two figures. Now the last one I will claim IA because this is the first year, then AA. Which year you are selling? 2015. So which year is the last year? 14. So 14 AA. So you have 650, 900, 450. Now I leave all the total for you. Okay? You just go back and calculate the total. Alright? So now I need the RE to work out how much is my BADC. Give me the RE, this one. 9? 9, 8. The first column. 2006. This one? 4,005. This one? 1,027. Okay. So you add up is 9, 9, 8. Okay, that's your RE. So in 2015 you dispose. So how much is your disposal value? 9,006. And what's your RE? 9,8. So you get a balancing charge or allowance? Allowance. How much? 200. Simple, huh? Like that. If they ask in the exam, this one example like that, easily is about 8 to 10 marks. See? You can do perfect. You can get perfect money. But you cannot do, like make mistake, for example, the calculation, until you make one mistake, everything go down all wrong. Not worth it. That's why I say you must be very perfect one. That's why I stress on listen to remember, understand. You go back and do again. Okay. Once you do again, you become perfect again. You become Superman in capital allowance. You become super capital allowance. Okay, please go to page 196. Now, let's test these. Section 39, you remember? Section 39 is about what? Can't remember, Deduction? Some more deduction? Anyone? That's why you see. Actually, deduction also you listen only, man. You don't write on. Deduction also nothing to write. Listen also don't remember. Section 39. Section 33 is what? Hiyo, this is not good. Okay, you better go back and go through again. Deduction is the second main thing you must know in your exam. Okay, Section 33 is the deduction condition. When you talk about wholly exclusive, is 33. 34 is the specific deduction. Example like EPF, contribution to library, okay, Then do a sponsorship to all these musical, okay, cultural, entertainment, okay, sorry, these sponsorship, okay. Now all that come under 34. All right. Now then 39 is what? 39 is the expenses that you are disallowed. Cannot claim one. Okay, disallowed. Now in 39 there are a number of disallowed expenses. One of the disallowed expenses come under. Now if you 39 also you cannot remember. I don't think you remember what is 39 1K lo. Huh? All right, you cannot remember it, okay? Now, K is for lease rental. When you rent motor vehicle. Got some idea how it works? How many thousand restrict? 100 or 50? Yeah, we have a restriction, 100 or 50. Now, but this restriction only applies to what kind of vehicle? Non-commercial. Commercial, no restriction. But rental is you rent, right? You're renting. So we restrict. What about if I buy? See, the government cannot be so stupid. You restrict the rent, you don't restrict the buy, then people buy. Then you're going to bypass the law, right? That's why to make it consistent, you rent, also we restrict. You buy, also we restrict. So no different. So that's why now there's a law come in for non-commercial vehicle. Okay, now the law basically says that I run on top, okay. For commercial vehicle, you can be unlimited. For non-commercial, right? Now the rule is the same with the rental. If you have a new vehicle and the cost of the vehicle doesn't exceed 150K, you can go up to 100. Now any vehicle that they are used or new but the cost more than 150, maximum 50. Okay? Now, so now we quickly run through. You see there's a table down here, right? Now I fill in, you don't fill in. You go back, you try one more time. Okay? Okay, first one. Commercial vehicle 500,000. What is the QPE? Okay. Commercial vehicle 500,000. What's the QPE? 500. Why? Commercial. You don't need to fill in. You go back and fill in one more time. Okay? Now non-commercial vehicle is new, the cost is 80. How much? 80. Okay? Because it's new. So you can go up to 100, all right? A used vehicle cost is 170, 50. A used vehicle cost 100, 50. A new vehicle cost 120, 100. A new vehicle cost 90, 90. A used vehicle cost 80, 50. Used. Not 80, it's 50. Okay, but go back and try again. So when your QP restricted, right? The CA naturally become restricted. So you cannot claim so much. Can you not? Now actually this law was created because they want to support a national made car. Okay? Which car that they are supporting? Those days they support Proton Perdana. Because Perdana is around that price. Okay? So if you buy Perdana, this price you claim full one. Okay? Because it's about 100,000. You take full amount. You don't lose. You buy a Honda, you buy a Toyota. Now Honda Camry now or Accord must exceed 150 already. Okay. Now, so if you buy a cheaper variant, for example, you buy the 130,000, you still lose. 130, you claim 100, you lose 30K. That's why the best car you buy is those car that exactly around 100K. So Perdana is the choice. Okay.
But
they
give promotion, they
sell
for 80,000.
80. Of course, incurred is 80. So then it's 80. 80. So the value is 80. The cost. Okay. Now, okay. Now we will come to this issue on disposal. Okay, listen, don't take, I go by and take. Because this one also another mistake area, always forget the rule, okay? Whenever you sell asset, you need to work out BABC, right? Okay, but there are some rule you must remember. The first thing you check, is it disposed within 2 years from acquisition? Okay? Are you selling the asset within 2 years? Dalam 2 tahun, 2 年内, you're selling it. Okay? Now, if let's say, for example, you buy the asset, if you buy the asset on the 4th of March 2015, within 2 years is when? 3rd of March 2017. So, up to 3rd of March, if you sell the asset outright, that's called within 2 years. But if it's after 3rd of March, then it's called after 2 years. After 2 years, no problem. Okay? Now, is it disposed within 2 years? No. More than 2 years, I sell. Then good. Then everything is normal. You just have to compute BABC. Give me the formula for BABC. What minus what? Disposal value minus RE. Okay? If you forget, please go back to accounting. Okay? Selling price minus NBV. And then convert back to tax. Then you will get the term money. Okay? Now, what if you sell the asset within 2 years? Because the government don't want you buy asset within 2 years, they sell. That's why they have some restriction here. But before they look at this restriction, you ask one more question. Is there any reason to justify the disposal? I mean, do you have a good reason that this asset that you dispose, there's a good reason why you sell them? Now, then you're going to ask, so what is good reason? Now, a good reason is either, now, in law, is because of death. The owner died. Now, example, I got a business. Now, I died already. So, when I die, I leave the business behind. Then my family member all, they don't want to run the business. So they want to close it down. To close down the business, what are they going to do? They sell all the asset. Now, old asset also sell, new asset also sell. So some asset maybe 2 months ago only I buy any, they also sell. So it's within 2 years, right? But is there a good reason? You ask the inland revenue, my husband died already. I don't sell, you want to buy? You want to do? You do? The inland revenue do not answer, you sell. See? That's why death is a good reason, okay? Someone died. Okay, another reason to sell is because the asset you buy, right? You bought the wrong asset. Okay, you bought the wrong asset. Now, what do you mean by bought a wrong asset? Now, let's say, for example, I want to change the projector. So, I'm not very good one. I also don't know. I go Lazada. I simply click. Wow, that one very cheap. I buy that one. Come back. I fit. When I fit, come out. Wow, the projection so small. It's only half of the size you see on the screen. Then the people at the back all cannot see. So how? I cannot use this projector, you know. So I buy also no use. So I quickly sell. I go to Muda Bot Mai. I sell back. So I own the projector less than 1 week only. I sell back already. So in that case, how? Then that is different. Because you buy an asset you cannot use. Can you see, you know? The asset is not suitable. So if you have a good reason to justify, then you do BABC the normal way. Okay. But if you sell asset within 2 years and somehow you got no reason to justify, then the government will punish you. How the government punish you? Government will tell you, whatever I give you, I take back. I don't want to give you. Can you see? That is the punishment. So we say, all the CA claim will be clawed back. We take back. Okay, you say take back. How to take back? Is it every year that you claim, you just go back to the year and then minus out? No. We take back by putting a balancing charge. So if all the year you claim first year, second, let's say you claim 5,000, 5,000, you claim 10,000, then when you sell, we put back balancing charge 10,000. So the effect is the same. So that is what we do. We claw back by way of a balancing charge in the YA of your disposal. Okay, so these are the rules. See, so many rules, you know. So you must make sure you remember. Go back and draw this chart yourself without looking at the computer. Okay, now, come back to this. So in the normal way when we work out BABC, we just take DV minus RE. Now the DV also got a rule one, okay? What is the rule for DV? DV is always the higher of proceed or the market value of the asset. Okay? Higher of proceed or market value. Now let's say for example this fan. When I sell the fan, I sell for 2 ringgit. But the fan cannot be 2 ringgit, right? Market value. Can say, maybe you say, no, the fan at least can sell for 30 ringgit. Then we take 30 ringgit. Even though I sell for 2, but the government will take 30 to calculate the BABC. So we must take the higher. Okay? Okay. Then one more issue you must be careful. The issue is car. For non-commercial motor vehicle, the DV must adjust one more time by taking the QPE divided by the cost. Okay? This is those things that, as I said, because the rules get a lot, they go exam, they all forget, they won't do all these adjustments. Okay? Now, why must you go and adjust the DV? Later I show you the number you can see. But you must understand the logic. When you claim CA, remember the car you restrict? Just now we look at this. The car you restrict. Now you see, this car, for example, this car I buy 170,000. But when I claim based on 50. The cost is so big. The CA start with so small. Then when I sell, right, of course my DV is big. But you take this big amount and minus a small RE. Very gone, very unfair. So how? You must restrict back the DV also. Then only you calculate. So how you restrict back the DV? You use this formula. You take the DV multiplied QPE over cost. Okay? Now, then you will minus RE. Okay, how do you get RE again? QPE minus IA claim. AA claim. See, not necessary you claim one, you know. Because first year, if your asset never used, you never have IA. Then there's no claim. So you must minus only you claim. Now, then you also minus NA. Now, this will be your RE. Normally, RE like that. Normally. Now, in a very special case. Now, what special case is this? This is cases. Now, for example, you imagine this place. We sign an agreement with the landlord. When we take the building, it's kosong. Everything kosong. But we build all the partition, everything we fix up like a college. Can you see? Okay? So let's say the agreement expire. We don't want to rent it. Then the agreement say, when you return this place to the owner, you must return back in the original condition. But this place like that is not original. Then what must we do? We must get people to come and take out all the partition, take out all the ceiling, take back all the aircon, everything must take out. And then restore back like the original condition. Now, when you do that, there's a cost you must pay, you know. Now, this cost can add to the RE. So, if you need to dismantle or you need to restore the place, the cost can add and make the RE even bigger. But this rule until now is never tested. So, I don't think it's important. Okay? But there's an adjustment there. Okay? Now, so that is what we will get as RE. Now, you see. So when your DV minus RE, if DV more than RE, what do you get? BC. Less means you get BA. Now BC also got the rule. The rule is what? BC is maximum. Cannot exceed allowances that you have claimed. You must restrict one. Okay, if you exceed, you must restrict. See, you forget to restrict, you lose mark also. Can you see not? Now, so this is the basic rule about how we do BABC. So this is the whole thing. Okay, so you go back, go through again, listen again, okay? Then you know how the rule works. Now, so once you go back, go through again, what you must do is you try back again the example here, page 198. So now I do one time with you. You go back, you try one more time. Page 198 and 199, there are four examples. If these four examples, you do perfect answer, well, congratulations. You're the superman of CA, okay? Then you go exam sure, no problem, okay? Now, we look at illustration one. Okay. It says that Barus, the year end is October. Now they buy a machine 18 March 2012. So class, 18 March 2012 is which year? Why? You must know the year because you must know which year you start to claim. Why? 12. Yes, this is why 12. Alright. Now they paid 70,000 for this machine. And they use it immediately. Dispose on 15 November 14. Now you check the date, you tell me. Within 2 years or more than 2 years? Huh? Within or more? More or deep. Because March you buy. So March 13, March 14. This is November, more than 2 years. But you tell me, November 14 sell is which year? Why? 15. So that's why you see, you didn't check the year end. What your mistake? Really serious one. You're going to make all the mistake in the year already. Can you see that? Now you're selling for 55,000. Okay. If I start from beginning, my QP is how much? 70. Case 1. Case 1. QP is 70. Okay. Now, first year is 2012. So my IA and my AA. So I claim 14, machine is 14%, so I will get 9,008. This some line, okay. Okay, then YA 13, I claim AA 9,008. Now 2015, I'm selling, right? YA November 14 is 2015. So you claim one more year, YA, 14, AA, 9,008. Now, so how much is my RE? So 70, 20, 66. Now, YA 15, I'm disposing. So my disposal value, how much? 55. So what do I get? Balancing charge 28,004. Now you ask yourself, 28,004 okay or not? Have you claimed 28,004? Now how much have you claimed? Now I've claimed 14,000. I've claimed 9,008. And you add up how many thousand already? 40 over 1,000. So I ask you, then 28,000 got problem or not? No problem. Okay, ma. Then this is the charge. This is the figure. That's the charge. Okay? Now, this is case one. Now, look at case two. Now, case two, I'm telling you, I only start using the asset 1st of November 2012. What's wrong if I only start using November 2012? Why? 13. Which year you buy? Well, 13 only you start using. So what's the problem? Yeah, the first year got no IA, no AA. Okay? Okay. Selling the same day. Okay? And you're selling it for 30,000 when the market value is 68. So which one you take? 68. Now later you must show in the answer. Now you see, if I put case 2 at the side by side there, case 2, I buy for 70. Can I claim IA? Cannot. Can I claim AA? Cannot. Anything else? Yes, notional. See? Wonderful. Now you understand it. Notional. How much? 9,008. Same rate. Now then 2013, I start using, right? So 9,008. 9,008. So now I dispose of this machine. So how much is my RE? 40,600. So what's my disposal value, class? 68. Now you must write in the exam one, you know, the answer must write. Huh? You must say is higher of the proceed market value 30 and 68. So you take 68. Right at the side, like that. Can. Okay. I mean, I don't encourage, but you write like that, we also have to give marks to you because you are not wrong. Okay. How not to give mark? We still have to give one. Although you write like that, we only feel annoyed and say that this student so untidy. Yes, you know? But we cannot fail you. As long as you're right, we cannot fail you. Okay? So but we cannot say that, I hate your answer, I don't give you mark, cannot. Okay. We all got moral one. The marker all got moral one. We don't simply fail people. If you deserve it, you must get the mark. So the BC become 27.4. Now you tell me what's the problem? It's 27.4, right? Yeah, okay. What's the problem? Now the problem is 9.8 and 9.8 is what you claim. Beto? Now this 9.8 on top, this one you never claim, you know, because this is not allowance, this is notional one, it's fake one. So now if you tell me the charge is 27.4, wrong already. Now you see some student, they stop there, and you lost one mark. Where is the one mark you lost? Because you never write. You must write at the bottom and say that BC is restricted to 9.8 times 2 is 19,006. Okay, you must write like that. Restricted to 19,006. Now, if you only say restricted to 19,006, probably you get half mark only. Not even one mark. Why 19,006? Because it's the actual allowances claim. You must write that. Restricted to the actual allowances claim. And the actual allowances is 19,006. Then one mark. Then you get BC, probably half mark. So some student never write this paragraph, you lost one mark. Okay. Now, so this is how we deal with disposal. Now, this is one part. Okay, please turn to page 199. Now class, I will show you the issue about this dismantling from this second example, okay? Because examiner never tested this, so I personally feel not so important. It's a very old thing already, okay? But I just want to show you how it works. Okay, LCT buy a power generator for 80,000 in December 2012. Now, which year of assessment is that? You must wait for the year end. I still don't know what's the year end. They spend 12,000 to install the generator. And they start using the generator in January 13 only. They use in January 13. They buy in December 12. In July 15, they cease to use the generator permanently and they dispose it for 28,000. But under the tenancy agreement with the owner, right, they have to dismantle the generator and restore the site to the original condition. So the company paid 15,000 for that purpose. Now this 15,000 is what I'm showing you. This one must do what? Must add to RE. So the year end December, okay, good. If year end December, which year you buy? 12. Which year you start using? 13. So now you know the problem. You skip 1 year. That first year you cannot claim one. Okay, now let's try this. Okay, so for LCT, what is my qualifying plant expenditure? 80 plus 12. You must write 80 is what? Cost, 12 is installation. Okay, so it's 92. Now, the year you start is 2012. IAAA, other ke tada? Tada, never use. So what do you do? Notional. So you have notional, the rate for notional, this is power plant, so it's 14%. You get 12,880. Now 2013 you start using, so you have AA 12,880. Which year you selling? 15. So the last year is 14. Very good. Okay. So 12,880. So now since you are selling, right? This should be the RE already. You stop there. So 92,000 you minus out is 53,360. Now I separate the figure so easier for you to see. So in 2015, my disposal value is how many thousand? 28. We're selling it for 28. And how much is my RE? Now by right is 53, by right. But in this case you must add the 15 and make the RE even bigger because you got a cost there. So you write down what is this. Okay? Dismantling cost. Restoration cost. So after you add the 15, the amount become 68,360. So minusing 28, what do you get? Balancing allowance 40,360. Now the whole example, nothing new one, you know, we've been doing the same thing already. The only new thing I show is which one? This one. Add the cost to the RE. Okay? You try and see, go and get a student, do F6 one. You tell them, you give them this example. I will assure you, they don't know where to put this 15. Then they simply put, alright? Either they go and show as disposal value or they add it together with QP. You see how dangerous is this answer. You take the 15, you add here. That means you're total wrong already. So what do you get? You get a working mark for the 80 and the 18. You get a working mark. Then the rest all wrong. Because everything wrong all the way down. So all wrong. Until where you get correct? DV you get correct. Then your BA, BC also wrong. So how many marks you get? Aiyo, so pitiful, you know. That's why the student go for CA question, I look at them, I always shake the head. Right? A lot of them are all get very low mark because of this are mistake. Be careful, so I don't want you to do like that. Okay, now we see illustration 3. Okay, so now is the time to test you. After you listen so long, you say, very boring. Today I don't move my hand. Okay, now is your time to move your hand. Please do illustration 3 for me. Must get perfect answer. No perfect answer, you overnight here. Okay. So about 10 minutes few more seconds only. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, time's up. Now I let you see how you make mistake okay. Pioneer made up the account 31st July annually. Purchase a used motor car. Used motor car. Used motor car. Why I say three times? Because QPE must restrict. If you say, ayo, forgot to restrict. Never mind. Okay, you lose a big chunk of mark only. Alright, now you start in the half purchase in April 11. Okay, 31st July is the year end. This motor car worth 60,000. You trade in the old car, that means deposit. So like that, then you loan how much? 35k. So you pay 20 money. So you divide by 20, then you know how much installment capital you pay a month. You start payment in May. If year end July, then it's 5, 6, 7, 3 month installment. Then you sell the car in April 2014, which is why 14 for 42k. Okay, so now I got all the details. So let's try and work out the answer. Okay, now. So my HP loan is 60 minus 25, so 35, So my capital repayment is 35 divided by 20. So it's 1750. So my QPE incurred in YA first year is 2011, 12 and 13. That is 25 plus 175 times 3. 175 times 12 and 175 times 5. So how much is the first figure? 3. 00 30250. Then followed by 20 1000. Then followed by 875. Now, so I show the CA first. So why 11, 12, and 13? Your QPE will be 30250, 19750 and new. Because you must restrict to 50k. Okay, so you put a note there lah, that maximum is 50,000. So for Y11 we have IAAA. So IAAA will be 60 50 60 50. Now YA12 also we have IAAA. I put a new here, then 60 50. Then the 19750. You have 3950 3950. Okay, then you add up the total yourself. Okay, now Y13 you only have AA 60 50 3950. The disposal happened in 2014. So this is my last year. I'm going to stop here. So when I stop here, my RE is 60 50, and then this figure is 7009. Now, so in 2014 we do a disposal. So I must first get my disposal value. So the disposal value is 42,000. Now, because you restricted the QPE, you must restrict the DV. So the amount will be 50 out of 60. 50 is the QPE, 60 is the cost, ma. Remember just now I gave you the formula here. Okay. If you are selling vehicle, you must do this. Okay. So you say, I forgot. Never mind. First time forgot. That's why I say you go back, you listen, then you do one more time. You won't forget one. Forever you remember. Then you go exam, you see this question. Then you thank me 1,000,000 times. Okay. Wow, how cai, Mr. Lau, 叫我回去再做过. Okay. Okay. Now, so you have 35k. So the 35,000 minus the RE. RE is how much? 13950. So you have a balancing charge of, is it 2150? 2150. Okay, so daddy got perfect mark. Huh? No. But you give me all the figure, I think you should get perfect mark. Wow, he even better. He don't even need to do already, he perfect. Wow, he's super perfect. Alright? That's why he's daddy standard. Huh? Okay? Just now you tell her daddy. You call me daddy. Just now. Okay, alright. Now, come back to this. Don't be sugar daddy lah, be a real daddy lah. Okay. Now, come back to illustration 4. Okay. Now, so illustration 3, I show you there. This incorporate a lot of things, you know. You see, this one example easily can go up to 10 marks already. Because I test a lot of things here. I test whether you understand non-commercial vehicle. I test whether you understand hire purchase. I test disposal. See, I test a lot of things that. It's a simple example, but you make one mistake, a lot of things go down all wrong. Okay? Now, I'll show you the last illustration here, illustration 4. Okay, this illustration 4 talks about clawback. Snopes year-end is 30th June. They buy two machines. Machine A, they buy 8,000 on the 4th of June 2012. The machine disposed of 5,000 on the 2nd of June 2014. Now you look at the date. June 4th, you believe. 2nd June, you jua. So is it within 2 years? Yes, this is within 2 years. So within 2 years, what happened? We have a clawback. Okay. Machine B acquired 5,000 ringgit on 15 June 2012. Disposed for 1,000 on 10th of June 2014. Is it within 2 years? 15 June you buy, 10 June you sell. Also within 2 years, right? This one is also within 2 years. But then they have a reason. They say because this is not appropriate for the business. So how? That means you can justify it. This one can justify. If you can justify, do we claw back? No, we won't claw back. This one will not claw back. So if not claw back, what you do? You do B, A, B, C like normal. Okay, so I'll do the first machine for you. Okay. First machine. Now class, what do you do with first machine? You're going to write in the answer. Because I'm sure examiner will ask you to explain one. So you have to say that the date you buy is 4th of June 2012. The date you sell is 2nd of June 2014. You must say like that. Because if you don't tell the date, how do you show it's within 2 years? They say which is a disposal within 2 years from the date of acquisition. Okay. Now, and you have to say that there is no justification for the disposal. Then all the CA claim will be clawed back. Okay, you must write like that. Okay, so you have to say within 2 years from the date of acquisition. Then all the CA claim will be clawed back as a balancing charge. You write like that. Clawback in which year? Clawback in the year you sell. That means clawback in YA14. Okay? Now, the year you sell. So how do you clawback now? The CA you start claiming is 2012, right? You're going to claim IA. How much IA? 20% of 8,000. So you have 1,006. Now, then you have AA. AA you claim. AA how many percent? 14% of 8,000. So how much is that? 14% of 8,000. 112. Now then YA 2013, you claim AA. 112. So now we claw back. So don't need to calculate disposal value. So straight away add up all these. So in YA 14, the balancing charge. That's all. Claw back. We take back. So 112. 3840. That is called clawback. So when I claw back as a BC, I ask you, so what have you got? Nothing. You claim these three, I take back as a charge. So you have nothing already. That's called a clawback. Now this is machine A. Okay, look at machine B. Now machine B, you have a reason for the disposal. Because you buy an asset which is not suitable. That one don't need to claw. So you don't need to claw, how? Don't need to claw, then you do like normal. Okay, if you do like normal, you can start like that. You can start telling me how much is the claim and how much is the IE. Maybe you start with QPE, 5,000. Now you bought this in 2012, so you got IAAA, IA 20%, 1,000, AA 14, 700. Now then YA 13, you claim one more year, AA 700. So this is your IE. 2006. Now in YA14, you have a disposal. Now you dispose it for 1,000. Your IE is 2006. So what do you get? Balancing allowance 1,006.
see, so simple.
This is same like what we've been doing. Nothing new one. Okay? Now, so all these are the issues on disposal. So we go back, please try again. Illustration 1, 2, 3, 4. You get perfect, then congratulations. Alright? That means you master the skill. Okay, can we now go to page 200? Okay. This one is a law that they introduced a few years back. And how important is this in the exam? Okay, so far I never seen this one. In fact, I thought examiner doesn't test this in F6. Got once I personally asked him, I said, hey, this one not in the syllabus. He somehow replied, no, it's in. Alright? So he told me it's in. Alright? But I cannot see in the syllabus they mentioned this one. So that's why I say I asked him, it's in or not? He said, yeah, it's in. Now, although it's in, but until now never been tested, I also cannot tell you it's important or not important, okay? But I must go through the rule with you. I tell you, if this rule you cannot remember, in exam come out, you sure go out. Maybe you don't know what to do, can you not? Now, so I'll explain to you. You listen, okay? You listen. Go back, then you do one more time. Now, what is called asset held for sale? You know, in accounting standard, now if you plan to sell an asset, you must reclassify the asset, right? That's why now your fixed asset got many categories. Asset held for use. Correct not? Asset held for investment. Asset held for sale. That means you want to sell it, you know. So that's why you see in the account, this asset, the shareholder know it, you want to sell the asset. Okay? Now, when you classify an asset that you want to sell, the problem is, how do you calculate the BABC? Now the government want to disturb us. The government say, I will come up with a rule about how you calculate BABC. Now the rule is like that. So let's say this is my year end. Okay, this is my year end. Let's say this is 31st December 2014 and 31st December 2015. Now class, the issue is here. Let's say on the 1st of May 14, you classify the asset. That means you already have intention, you want to sell it. You classify. Now the moment you classify, that means you have the heart, you want to sell it. So now my question is, when did you sell the asset? So you have three possibility. One, you sell the asset here. That means in the same year itself, you sell it. Okay, or you only sold the asset second year. That's the second possibility. This year I classified, but I only sell it second year. Now that I put a date, let's say this is 1st of September, this is 1st of July, okay, 2015, sorry. Okay, 1st of July. Now the third possibility is what? Third possibility is up to the year end, the asset still not sold. Up to the year end, the asset not sold. You say you want to sell, but until the year end also never sell. Okay? Now, so in these three cases, how that it will affect us in terms of calculating BABC. Okay, we take the first case. Now, for the first case, when we calculate BABC, the formula for disposal value, now you tell me the rule again, disposal value is what? Higher of market value or what? Proceed. Okay. You take higher of market value or proceed. The law say for these cases, when you classify asset that you want to sell, the market value is the market value always. Look back. By right, we should take market value on the 1st September, but in this case, no. We take market value on 1st of May 14. We take the market value you classify. Okay. Now, if your year end December, right, we say year end December. Now, you sell in which year? Y 14. Okay, you sell in Y 14, right? Y 14. So if you sell in Y 14, can I know your RE you claim until which year? The CA you claim until? CA claim up to 2013. Very good. Now, that's the formula. So you say, oh, like that only, is it? Like that only. That's the first case, like that. Now, second case, a little bit tricky. Now, Now, second case, you only sell the asset the second year. So the disposal, okay, give me the year you're selling now. YA? 15, okay. So the disposal value is higher of market value or proceed. So the market value is what market value? Which date? 31st December 14th. We use this day. So look back. You just look back. 31st December 14th. Not 1st of May. 31st December. Okay? Now then when you minus the RE, so the CA, can I know you claim until YA 1/4. Because now it's 1/5 already, ma. So 1/4 you claim one more year. Now, not only that, well, you also need to have notional allowance for Y15 also. The one who say the law say. There's a special thing. Not only the market value is different, the notional allowance also very different. You must do one more year notional allowance for 15. Okay? Now, then this is the third scenario. The asset not sold. Not so how? Not so we deem dispose on 31st December 15. You don't sell also, the government say, never mind, we assume you sell already. So if assume you sell, then why 15 must do what? Disposal value. Now, normally formula is higher of market value or proceed, right? Hey, this one not sell, where got proceed? I didn't sell. That's why no proceed. That's why the government say what? This is the market value on December 15th. Because you got no proceed. Then you minus RE. This RE is the same RE as this. Same one. Because it's the same year. Ma. Okay. Now we look at this. If you say the asset not sold, then after that you sell the asset here. You sell it. Then what happened? Nothing happened. Because you already calculated the BABC. Ma. You already calculated the BABC assuming you dispose of it. Then nothing happened. If you sell. La. What if you change your mind? You say, I don't want to sell. I want to use back the asset. Now I change my mind. Now here, on the 1st of March 16, you use back the asset. You use back the asset, must claim CA, right? But you already disposed already. Well, how to claim CA? The government assume you buy back. So if you say assume buyback, then buyback is on what up what price? We will assume that your QPE equals to the market value on the day you use back. But you say, so I buy back, that means first year, right? So first year, then I will start again, IA, AA, 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 like that, right? Correct or not? Then can I claim IA? The law say cannot. You cannot claim IA. No IA. These are the rule. Okay? Now, I don't think it's so important. So what you do is, you go back, you listen one more time, you agak-agak remember, okay, dear. Don't need to spend so much time on these other things. Okay? Unless you're so sway. So many years they don't ask. You go exam only they ask. Okay, but you don't worry. If they ask also, I can give you assurance. 1,000 students take F6. The one can do maybe less than 100 only, because most students don't care. Man, you see, you trust me. And the 100 maybe inside 20 are y'all. So happy. Okay, after you listen like that. Okay, now back to this page 200. Now we see the illustration. Time also running out. Okay. Now, on the 19th of July 2013, ESS classified factory machine as held for sale. So this date classified. The market value on the date on that day is 40,000. They bought it in August 2010 for 80,000. The year end is 30th June. Okay, case 1. The machine sold for 41,000 on the 20th October 13. So you tell me 20th October 13 is which year? Okay, why 14? You tell me the year they classify is which year? Why? Why? 14 also, yeah. Because year end June, ma. So 14. So same year or second year? Same year. That means you're following which rule? Rule number one. So I do this one with you first. Okay? Rule number one. Now. So what I'll do is, I will take for case one, okay, I'll take YA 14, the disposal. The DV is the market value on what? On the day you classify, which is 19 July 13, or the proceed. Now, the day you classify, market value got 40K. But they sell for 41K. So we must take 41, the higher. Okay. My qualifying plant expenditure is 80,000. That's what I bought it for. Can I know the year I buy is which year? 2011? 1? 10 or 11? 2010 or 2011? 11. Because year end June. Ma. So your IA got 20, your AA got 14. Now you tell me, you claim AA until which year? 2013. So 2012, you claim AA. Then 2013, you claim AA. So I straight away times 2. Okay? Now, so that means you have 27.2, 22.4. So your RE is 30,400. Now, that means what do you get? Balancing charge. 10,006. That's the balancing charge in 2014. Now this is case one. Sell in the same year. Now I would like you all to try, okay? Because we got not much time. So I finish this, I'll let you go back in. So I like you all try, okay? You try case two for me. Now in case two, the machine sold for 25,000 on 1st August 14. And 1st August 14 is YA 15. That means the second year. So the market value is 27. The market value on 30th June 14 is 26. So YA 15 is your disposal. So your DV is higher of market value on 30th June 14, or the proceed. So the market value is 26. You're selling for 25. So we take 26. What's my RE? Okay, the RE as at end of 13 is 10. Sorry, it's 30,004. But I take the same figure here. Continue, ma. That one is 13. But you must claim one more year, right? YA 14, you must claim AA. So the AA will be 11,002. Now then, YA 15 must have notional allowance. 11,002. So the RE now become 8,000. So you have a balancing charge of 18. That is the result for case 2. Okay, case 3. Now the machine was not sold as at 30th June 15. Okay, so the moment you tell me 30th June 15 also not sold, then I must do what? Deem disposal here. So the market value on 30th June 15 is 32. In fact, it has been put back to use on 1st September 15 when the market value is 30,000. Now, so when you say you didn't sell, right, I will deem dispose. and the market value is market, the disposal value is market value on 30th June 15, which is 32. Now the RE is the same as this, same figure, you get 8,000. So you have a balancing charge of 24. Okay, now I have no problem with 24, I've claimed more than that, okay. Then in 2016, because you put back to use, when you put back September 15, it's 2016 already. So the qualifying plant expenditure become the market value on the date you use back, which is 30. So YA16 is the first year, so you should take IA88, but you got no IA because the law says cannot claim IA. Then the AA become 14% on the 30K. You start all over again, 14% on the 30K. So you get 4,002. Now this is the third case. Okay. Now this is how it affects you if you didn't sell the asset at the end of the second year. Okay. Alright, so I think we have done quite substantially all the rules. Okay. But before we finish, just one last one. I just want to tell you the idea only because I don't think this one will apply in the exam. Now, page 201. Now, there's this new law that they added into the budget last year, okay? Budget 2015, all right? 2016, sorry. Now, so what is this? Now, they are saying that if you have an asset that you depreciate them separately. Now, why would an asset that you will have depreciation separately? Now, this will normally apply to asset like what? Like aeroplane. Because aeroplane is very expensive asset. So what happened is there are certain part in the aeroplane got lifespan one. Maybe the aeroplane can fly for 50 years. But maybe, I don't know aeroplane. Maybe the engine can only use for 20 years. So after 20 years, you must change the engine. But the engine is not cheap. So that's why after 20 years, you replace the engine. So what you do is you have to depreciate the engine separately. Because the lifespan is all different. So in that case, every time when you change the part, do you call this as repair or not? You see, if you look back into our concept of repair, actually it is a repair because we are changing a part. But in accounting standard, we say that this is not repair because the part has a very long useful life. That's why in accounting standard, what they do is they depreciate the asset separately. So every time when they change one part, that part alone, they will depreciate again using a different formula. So now the tax try to follow this accounting rule. They are trying to say, if you have any asset that you depreciate separately, the moment you dispose the part, you change the part, then we will treat that you also dispose it in the tax. And when you dispose it, you have to calculate again the CA. So how do you calculate the CA? Now then you must take qualifying expenditure, same amount as the amount determined in the accounting standard. So the accounting part, they will calculate. Now because we don't learn the accounting part, so how are they going to test you in the tax, right? Now that's why I don't think this is likely, okay? Now, so what we're telling you is, it will also affect the tax, so that you have to calculate again a separate disposal, BA, BC for the part, and you have to claim the CA again for that part. Now that's the issue to do with asset depreciated separately. Now, it's just for you to know, I don't think it's for exam, okay? Alright, so that's the last issue we have here. Now we only have a few more areas to finish off, so I'll continue with you the next class. Okay, now class, because this topic, as I say, in exam, I can almost say guarantee come out. But I have seen so many students that they make a lot of weakness. And as I say, you make one mistake, the whole thing can become wrong one. So I don't want you all to do this sort of mistake in the exam. I will go back and convert the video. I'll share to you all in the group. You go back and do again, okay? Watch again. Those blank you do again and then check the video. Please, okay? Very important topic.